Good morning. P-0171, P-0174, lean codes, 2000 Suburban, 412,000 kilometers on the clock. There's a little trick that a lot of professional mechanics forget to teach when they're showing people how to work up lean codes. I'm going to show you that little trick right now. So I've got you in live data now. Just to have a quick glance at the upstream oxygen sensors, bank one and bank two. These are narrowband oxygen sensors, and you can see that they're fluctuating right about perfectly. So while we're waiting for it to go into closed loop, let's have a little discussion about what causes lean codes. The lean codes, of course, are an imbalance of air to fuel, the air to fuel ratio. And so it'd be a problem with not enough fuel or too much air. Does that make sense? Now, the not enough fuel angle is going to be things like fuel delivery, the fuel pump, fuel quality, ethanol, that kind of thing, even injectors. And then the too much air is by far the most common cause. In fact, the most common cause of all lean codes is a vacuum leak, where air is being sucked into the intake through a hole in something. And how do you differentiate those? Well, a couple of other causes worth thinking about. One is the mass airflow sensor itself. And let's just look here. And right now it's going to about 5.5 grams per second. And is on a 5.3 engine, which it is here, then you want about 5.3 grams per second, and we're just dead on there. And that's just as a rough rule of thumb. Now watch what happens when I snap the throttle. Mass airflow goes way up. And so that's not really fitting with the mass airflow sensor problem. Now the other issue with the mass airflow sensor, the classic presentation is rich at rest, lean under load. Now that doesn't always happen, but it's worth memorizing. Rich at rest, lean inner load. And it relates to the fact that you get dirt on that mass airflow sensor, and it doesn't, it takes the top off the peak flow. And so it tends to worsen when you snap throttle. It tends to, if anything, worsen. It certainly doesn't get better when you snap throttle. And that gets to the gist of the point I'd like to make here. And that is that with a vacuum leak, what you expect is you expect these numbers to improve. Now I'm going to step on the throttle, and I want you to watch the short-term fuel trim on both sides and just see what happens. Here we go. So we're... Look at that. So my short-term fuel trims have gone negative, improving. And in fact, the long-term fuel trims are improving as well. And so that's a characteristic finding with a vacuum leak. Let's see on this bank. Yeah, I got smoke here too.